Okay, hi everyone, and welcome to the latest this month's European Chats with Congress webinar. And I'm very happy to present Zita Seba, who's with me all the way from Switzerland. Do you want to say hi?
Hi, everybody.
So we're going to start off as usual with the European Chats with Congress video trailer. Okay, so that's the intro trailer. And now it's my chance to embarrass Zita by introducing her.
Just by the
So here she
picture.
is. And this is all information I got from the European Shiatsu Congress website. So it's not my fault if it's wrong. So you've been a Shiatsu therapist for more than 30 years, and you had initially your diploma with a Ahashi. And then you did quite a lot of work with Pauline Sasaki, Quantum Shiatsu. And then you've been working together with Tetsu Saito since 2000. So that's really quite a long time now. You specialized in the Shinto Shiatsu, and you're also doing psycho-spiritual trauma therapy. I thought that was very interesting as well. And you founded the Shinto Shiatsu Institute in Europe, and you're teaching internationally. Well, not right now, of course, but generally you are. So there we are. I just stopped sharing that, and then we can get on to the main slides. Okay, so I'm gonna put your main slides up, Zita, and it's all yours. I'll keep an eye on the chat. If everyone wants to say hi from where you're from, we've got well over 100 people coming in, and we've got more and more people coming in all the time. So welcome to the webinar. And here's Dinah. She's gonna help us out with
Hi.
looking after the chat.
Thank you.
Hi. So over to you.
Thank you for introduction. And I
That's
think it's
welcome.
quite international today or tonight.
Very international. We've got people from all over America, France, Spain, Netherlands, Croatia.
And some of you I know from Vienna. Remember, we danced together at the final party.
All right, that's the last. Dinah, I wonder if you just want to turn your mic off because I think I can get here a little bit of an echo there. I wonder if it's coming through your. Yeah, that's better. Yeah, that's great. Thanks. Thank you. That's great. Okay. Yes. Sorry.
So tonight, I tell you about Shinso Shiatsu, and because this is really what I've learned the last 20 years, and I apply, and it's wonderful. And you just can oh, I can make the slides. Oh, how? Sorry for now.
Yep, you just hover your mouse in the thing and then click them. Or I can do it for you if you
Now,
want. There we are. Yes, you did it.
I got
Brilliant.
it. Okay, this is in Vienna when I replaced Ted Saito. He couldn't come. So,
Oh, yes.
yes. So next time in Amsterdam, I'm really officially replacing him, not just jumping in like in Vienna.
Yeah, brilliant.
So let's go to the content of this class. We will see what is Shinso Shiatsu and who is Tetsuro Saito for the ones who don't know him, and what is his contribution to the Shiatsu world. And I want to show you a cool diagnostic tool, and also we want to try it out and have fun with it. Ready for that?
Okay. Yep. Someone's saying you're a bit quiet, so you might want to just speak up a bit.
Okay,
Maybe just
maybe
turn
I
your phone.
put on my microphone more.
Yeah.
Or they can put on their computer the microphone.
Yeah, that's it. I can hear you fine now. I think you're fine.
Yeah.
Yep. Great. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, no. This is a this. So now it's the poll. Next, first poll.
Okay, right. Okay, here we go. So it's what is Shinso Shiatsu? Yeah, that's the first poll, right?
What is Shinto Shiatsu?
Yes. Yeah, okay, here we go. So here's a poll for you. Choose the closest answer in your opinion. A strange form of mountain climbing, a very strange and difficult shiatsu style, deeper level shiatsu, invented in Switzerland or based on Zen shiatsu. You asked for that. You asked for that.
Okay, so as we are in Switzerland, it's obvious a strange form of mountain climbing. And maybe not so strange and difficult, deeper level shiatsu, mm-hmm. Okay. And it's unfortunately not invented in Switzerland. It's invented in Toronto.
And Toronto, Canada, yeah.
Very good, based on Zen shiatsu. So, yeah. And this Ted is explaining here, he has to climb this mountain always with his research, and then finally he has the overview there of the meridian system and what's going on down there. Yeah, he really likes mm-hmm. this picture or this image. So here we have the answers. And who is Tetsuro Saito? He moved in the 71, he moved from Japan to Toronto and founded shiatsu. There was no one knowing shiatsu at all. So he had to really he had a really hard start there to promote his work and he made a school there and so on. And then Masunaga would come over to him every year two times, I guess. And then after he died in the 81, Ted was really left alone with all that Masunaga's findings. So he developed it further and further. He wanted to really understand in depth. So he is one of the most talented shiatsu masters of our time. Still living there, and I experience him as really very dedicated to shiatsu. All his life he just did this research and worked 6 days on a row, and in the evening he would take his cup of tea and go to his office and just research again and dream of it, and in the morning he went and tried it out on his clients. It's really very dedicated and humble and very joyful. I hope you will meet him one time. And I hope he's here in this webinar. Didn't see him on the chat yet.
No. Maybe he's going to be turning up. I don't know. Yeah. Or I don't know what time it is in Canada. During the day sometime, I think it is, isn't it?
Yeah, it's 2:30 there.
Yeah, it's during the day.
So quickly, the benefits of Shinzo Shiatsu. We are working with deeper meridian systems. So not only the regular systems as many of the shiatsu people do, but we are integrated the extra meridians and so on. I tell you later. Ted completed all the meridian charts on all the levels, and for him he said only yesterday on the phone, he said, tell them diagnose is the most important, because if you have no clear diagnose, then how we can treat, how we can really focus on our treatment, how we can structure our treatment. It's really, diagnose is the most important. So that's why I put this red for you and for him. So, and of course, powerful.
So you told him about this, you told him you were doing this webinar, did you? Yes. He knows about this webinar.
Yes.
He does, oh, great. Well, if he can't make it today, we can always send him a link so he can see.
Yeah, he has the link.
That's great.
He has the link.
Oh, yes. Yeah. But we can show him the recording anyway if he doesn't make this live event.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So hi, Ted, if you're watching this, hi Ted.
Hi Ted. So grateful. Yeah, I'm really grateful.
Okay.
So the treatment is very powerful because you are working with the deeper meridian systems. you can really work on the cause and also because of the clear diagnosis. And of course, it's easy to integrate in any shiatsu style. It's not a shiatsu style itself in a way. It's just tools you can use in your own shiatsu art. So,
can I just ask you a question myself? When you say the deeper meridians, do you, you're probably going to say this now, but do you mean like the more fundamental channels, you know, like the conception vessel and the what do you actually mean by the deeper layers? Maybe you're going to tell us now.
Yes, finding deeper layers.
Yeah.
So.
Ah, right. Okay, here we are. Yes, good.
So, you know all the 12 regular meridians. And then most of you know the extra meridians, the 8 extra meridians. Like the conception vessel, governor, and the other ones, belt and so on.
Yes.
So these ones overflow into these ones if they have too much ki or too much chakra. Also, they come and help. And here we have the divergent meridians. They diverge from the superficial regular meridians. They diverge into the depths, into the body, into the organs. So this is the organ level. And then we have the ocean meridians. We have had a webinar about the ocean level.
Yes, the seas. Yes, I remember.
The seas. So this is the ocean meridians. It's meridians, of course, there. And then we have the cosmic system. The cosmic meridians, they just go around. They are just not in the body, but around the body and connect us to the cosmic. So, so we always exchange energy with the cosmic. So this is the cosmic meridians. For us.
Yes.
And we have all this theory explained in the handout. You will.
Do you want me to share that?
So I really don't want to get so much into theory to be able to share with you some practical things.
Yeah, so do you want me to share the handout now?
Not.
Or just wait for it later.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. We have got a handout.
So I have an next poll for you.
Okay. Oh, yes, the next poll. Okay. Is that the, do you sometimes doubt your Hara diagnosis? Is that the one?
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. So this is the next poll we have for you, which is, do you sometimes doubt your Hara diagnosis? Yes, maybe, no. There's very honest people you've got on your webinar. They're very honest.
And to be honest, I was so unsure about my diagnosis many times, often. And when I met Ted Saito, luckily, I really get this tool of the finger test, and then I really get a clear diagnosis, and I never doubt again, or rarely. So, I'm not.
Yeah, I can remember when after Vienna, we had that lovely after the live event, we had a webinar with Gabriella, and you were on it. And I remember you teaching us all to do it on the webinar. So that was that was an interesting experience. No doubt we're going to do that again.
Yeah,
in a minute.
I have to, because you didn't do it, Cliff. You didn't
What's that?
Use it, so I have to teach you again.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly. But then again, you see, I don't ever doubt my Hara diagnosis, so I'm okay.
Yes, you're okay.
I'm one of the 14% there.
But like this, you can really confirm. So.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Anyway.
Okay, here we go.
I invite you to get clear. And I ask you if you are ready for a new diagnostic pills.
Okay.
Based on sound frequency resonance. So this is the next poll, I guess.
Okay. The next poll I've got is, can you get these two sensations?
No. Okay. If are you ready? You can just put your
thumbs
up if you're
ready. All right. Okay. Yeah. Just put your thumbs up in the in the chat if you're ready for, you put thumbs up. Yes, they're pretty ready.
These ones are amazing.
Lots and lots of thumbs up. Brilliant. Excellent.
Okay. In this case, one way is the finger test.
Right. Okay, cool. Yes.
This is a very special group in Switzerland. They are from the very beginnings and we're still together. They're very experts. And I hope they're on it on the webinar. Two of them.
Yeah, brilliant. Brilliant.
So this finger test is developed not by Tetsuya Saito, but by Tadashi Irie. So Tadashi Irie was an acupuncturist, master, and a university professor, and he developed that because his students with this pulse diagnosis, it's so difficult, and he wanted them to quickly and really precisely get the diagnosis, not after 10 years experience. So that's why he developed that. And then Ted would adapt this finger test, ask him permission, and he gave the permission to Ted to use it and to teach it. And Ted gave me the permission to teach it to you. Okay, this is the next. Before I teach it to you, this finger test, I really would like to do a small meditation with you, so that we are really sure we are centered and grounded, because it's really much better if you're grounded to perform it and to feel it. Is it okay?
Yes. Yeah, of course, yes.
So then I invite you to close your eyes. And get in touch with your breath. And let your breath lead you to the belly, to the sacrum, the root, feet, and send your root, your light root, in the speed of light to the through the earth, to the heart of the Mother Earth. With love and respect and care. And from there, take her love, her support, her nourishment, back up at the speed of light, through your roots, through your feet, through your legs, through your spine, and back your head up into the sky. Another light roots to the source. Nourishment of love and light from above, back to your soul star, your crown, into your heart. Stay there for a while. Connection to the heart, the shiatsu world, and the other world. And then let the from the heart just flow it into your hands. And then take the deep breath and open your eyes. Hope you feel well. Ready for explanation.
Yep.
Okay. So the finger test works like a TV set. If you want to watch TV, you have an antenna, and this antenna is picking up all kind of waves and vibrations. And then you need a tuner to really select or choose what you want to see. Like you want to see a movie, you want to see football, you want to see a documentary. So you have really to choose. Otherwise, if you don't choose or you just click around on your tuner, it's the image is kind of like that. So it's really important, the tuner. And then you have a screen, you have an outcome. So that's exactly how the finger test works. You have a sensor, this is one hand, and then you have a tuner, it's the other hand, this is the finger test. So let's see now how we can perform this finger test. First of all, if you begin to use it, it's best you remove all the heavy jewelries. And you get out of the electrosmog and of the strong magnetic fields like a fan or an earth disturbance or a water under all these interference fields. They will disturb the test. So then choose one hand, one, or let one hand say, hi, I want to do it. So choose it. And now I might go up. See me still? So then relax your shoulder and wrist, and the chosen hand, this is my left here, and I overlap the thumb, and the index finger. Can you see? And then slide your thumb slowly. And now I change this, so, and then you can see this is also the left hand. So it's the inside of the index finger and the inside of the thumb. And you can slide. Is it working?
Yep.
Okay. So. And you can get two sensations. Here you can see Ted doing finger test in a seminar, and one sensation is sticky, it's like a glue or a moisture, and one outcome is like before, like smooth. We call that smooth if it really slides. You say slide, is okay, slide?
Yes, slide, yeah, freely,
so,
yeah.
You know, my English is Swiss English and maybe some mistakes in here. Also
no, it's very good. It's very good English. Don't worry about it.
Thank you. So, and now...
It's feeling a bit sticky. My hand's feeling a bit sticky already, though.
Now...
What does that mean?
Okay. So, I want you... I give.
Actually,
you...
this side is smoother, though. This one's smoother than the, this side is smoother.
Yes, take the...
Which... The smoothest side.
No, whatever feels comfortable for you. For me, left hand is very comfortable because the right hand can go over the heart of the client.
The testing.
Yes.
You know what? I think I'm better at this with this one. Anyway, sorry.
It's really good. That's what people experience now.
It's really good. Smoother on this side. Yeah.
Please choose. It is that we are experimenting.
Yeah. I think I'm going to choose this one this time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah, go on.
Okay. And now I give you time to get something to really experiment. Go and get some cigarettes or some painkillers. Or
I don't have any of them.
Or your dishwasher.
I'll do that. What about toilet cleaner? Do you think toilet cleaner would work?
Very good. Even better.
I'll go and get the toilet cleaner. Just don't go away, Zita. I'll be back in a minute.
Everyone can go and get that. We are waiting. Delicious.
It is ecological toilet cleaner, though. It's eco-vert. It's probably not too deadly. It's probably better for you than cigarettes, if I could probably drink it.
Yeah, that's exactly the point, Cliff. Because this is maybe some people even can have the cigarette or smoke, but we really want to have something in your hand that, or in my right hand, something in your hand that really is not good for you. So you experience a sticky sensation. So now, I don't know if everybody's here and got something.
As everyone will ask them, have you got thumbs up? Have you got something like cigarettes or painkillers or toilet cleaner or something to put in your hand? Yep, looks like it.
What you want to drink? What you want like to drink?
Sorry?
Okay.
Yeah, everyone's ready. Let's go.
Okay, let's go. I take the painkiller. So.
Yeah, okay.
This is my right hand. This is my antenna hand.
Okay.
This antenna. This is enough. I put this. This is a vibration painkiller or a dishwashing dish thing cleaner.
Liquid.
This okay, liquid. So this is the antenna, and then my tuner is my question. So one clear question, and the one clear question is that good for me? Or shall I take this? Or shall I smoke this? Or in your case, Cliff, shall I drink this? Shall I drink this whole bottle? And then you don't think about it. So what is really important, and Masunaga also said, when you diagnose, just put away your mind. And that's exactly the case in the finger test. So put one question, drop your attention to the horror, and then just ask, shall I take this? Or is it good for my system? And then do the finger test. This is my right hand. So, and you just one question and slide your thumb and index finger, and you don't care what is the result. So stickiness.
I really do care, because I don't want to have to drink this toilet cleaner. I tell you, I really do care. It's important to me. You might not be bothered, but I'm going to be really sick if I drink this.
So is it sticky or not?
Anyway, luckily for me, I don't have to drink it, because my fingers were so sticky.
Very sticky.
Yeah, it's amazing.
So is it?
You know what? I felt it in my whole body. It wasn't just in my finger. I felt a weird feeling inside. I think it was just the thought of drinking this toilet cleaner. I mean,
so that's a really good point, what you're saying, because we feel the diagnosis, we feel the energy system of our clients, this the finger test is a good confirmation, something clear, something very precise, what we can say, yes it's really sticky, I shouldn't.
I see what you mean. It's because you do get lots of other sensations in your whole body, don't you? But it is a very specific, it's just like a very specific, just one thing that you can concentrate on. I can see that.
But you shouldn't really concentrate on. You should just go to your tandem.
Right. You concentrate on the alignment, right?
Yes. Just the question, tandem, and then let it slide. Because if you have too much concentration on this, it doesn't work. It just does.
No.
It's just the mind interfering, or we are back ten.
No, I see what you mean. Yeah, no, you do. You have to keep it aligned. You have to keep your alignment.
Yeah, we're just like a mouse, the cat before the mouse, the mouse hole.
Yeah.
You have that in English, the cat in front of the mouse hole? No.
Yes.
Don't be. Okay. So.
So you need to keep aligned, and you need to keep the intention on the question, don't you? And then it works.
Yes. You're right. It works very naturally. It's nothing you are good on it, or you can achieve, or something is a natural flow, it's just a resonance. That's why it's resonance test, frequency resonance. So the frequency of these painkillers are not really matching the frequency of my body, my system. So that's why it's sticky. And this is just for trying out, just to give you this sensation. So let's see if you, I think it's the poll, the next poll, isn't it?
Probably. I just
too much finger testing.
Wait a minute. Okay, let's have a look. Can you get these two sensations? Yeah, the two sensations, the smooth and the sticky. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
So let's
just find out whether you've got those two sensations. Did everyone get them?
Oh, many.
Mostly did. Wow. Yeah, you did well. You did well. Very good. Yep. You've got 60% or over 60% said yes, 18% maybe, and 22% no. I wonder why people didn't get it. Maybe the thing wasn't bad enough for them, or they didn't focus on their alignment enough. I wonder what went wrong. Oh, well.
Sometimes it's not wrong. It's just a matter of trying. Don't give up.
Sure.
Just this is your first try, you know. Then next time you take something really not good, like this, for instance, like this. So you will get very sticky.
What? That's a chocolate rabbit. What's wrong with a chocolate rabbit? It's Easter. It's just been Easter. Come on, I think that's too bad. I'm sure my finger test would be like slipping like mad if I had that in my hand. I would be smooth as anything. It really would be.
My advice is never.
How can a chocolate rabbit be worse than toilet cleaner? I mean, come on, Zita, give me a break.
No, advice,
I know what I bother
with. My advice is never, never, ever test chocolate if you want to eat it.
Rachel said she got slightly sticky with washing up liquid, but very smooth when she tried it with a biscuit. So there you are, you see.
So.
Oh, dear. Okay, yeah, sorry. So I'm getting a bit overexcited.
I think it's a time for the video.
Okay.
Let's little bit work. Serious now.
Okay. I'm serious. Yeah, let's try it.
It's a very serious matter.
Yeah, I hope it's going to start in the right place. If not, I'll fast
let me see
it,
if it's really. No. I go with that first. Sorry. So,
okay.
Like that, what we did now. No. Oh, you did.
Sorry. Yes. Sorry.
Like that, you can now test for yourself. You can use this test in order to really get in tune with that. And this is like a new language. You have to practice every day, but playful, very playful. So take your whatever, take your fruit or take your minerals, for instance, your minerals, and then you put on your hand and be sure that it's not the aluminium foil, it's really sealing off. So you have to put it the other way around. So you touch not the aluminium, but the tablet. And then if you do that, you can ask is this mineral good for me? Is this vitamin C or D or whatever good for me? How many, for instance? So you go from smooth to sticky. Let's say 2 is okay, and 3 is already sticky.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Everything smooth is good for you. Drinks or supplements or foods. When I go with Ted to the restaurant, for instance, he loves to go to the restaurant. And he's really suffering at the moment because all restaurants are closed. So if we go to the restaurant, we take the menu, and then we test the menu and we test, is this good for me? Is this? And this, we don't order the sticky things, for instance.
Good. No.
Even like that,
Very
you
much.
really can playfully test things out in your daily life.
Yes.
So now
Yes.
we can see what Ted does with it.
Do you want me to play the
Yes,
video
yes.
now?
In
Yeah?
Shiatsu, you can use it. Or
Okay, let's hope that it starts in the right place. If not, I'll fast forward it. It was 2 minutes something,
No,
wasn't
it
it?
was 126.
126. Okay, let's just see. We're going to play a YouTube video. Let's just see if it works. Okay, I'll fast forward it. 126. Okay, let's see if this works.
Okay, put your two finger over the bladder line.
Now you can play it. We can hear it. Yes, we can hear it. We could hear it. When you put out your tone, we could hear it. Just play it. It was okay.
Okay. Our shinso shiatsu, like using the finger test. Okay. Our shinso shiatsu, like using the finger test, and you can locate it very easily, this shoe point. For instance, river. Where is the river shoe point? Okay. Put your two finger over the bladder line, and image is river. River, 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 river. In case comes two finger on the point, right away you can sense sticky. This is a river shoe point. Okay, triple heater, triple heater, triple heater, triple heater, right away sticky. Okay, so this is the way you find out and you treat. Okay, this is a shoe point which connecting to directly organ. It's a very important point.
Sorry, I just had to mute myself because some people were getting a bit of an echo there through my mic. So I just, but it did play. We got it there in the end. That was amazing to watch it. Amazing to see how he applied it to the U point there. I'm just going to get the, there we go. Yeah, oh, that's so interesting. I hadn't thought about that, actually testing points like that.
We test everything.
Yeah.
We test everything.
Yeah, I see. Yeah. If it didn't, it's quite a big deal to get YouTube videos to go through the pipe to you. So if your connection wasn't brilliant, you may not have seen all of that video, but don't worry, because what we'll do is we'll send you a link to the video when we email out the recording. So don't worry about that.
Well, the link is in the handout. You have
It's in the handout. Oh, brilliant. Okay. So we'll
get YouTube videos.
Excellent. You've already thought of it. You're very organized, Sita.
Yeah.
Very organized.
I tried my best.
Yeah. Okay, great.
So actually you said you wonder what we use it for the points. Yes, you can use it for any finding point. That's also why acupuncturists are using the finger test.
Right, to test points and test the pulses or anything like that.
And the points, they are finding the points. And then it's sticky. You go from smooth to sticky.
Yes.
When you,
brilliant.
Yeah, and you can find the meridians. You can find your three heater, for instance. It says three heater, three heater, three heater, three heater, and then you have a sticky. You
yes.
hit the meridian. It's a really, really very, or you can find the position. You can find the position of the heart, 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 and then it stops, or liver, 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 liver.
So this is a good question from Emmanuel. She says, though, if you feel and you get a stickiness on a point, does that mean you should work the point then? Because something's wrong with the point. Is that how you interpret it?
It depends your question. If you well,
Ah, of course,
if you
yeah.
put a clear question, where is the point? Then it's showing the point is here. If you put the
Of
question,
course.
which point shall I treat? Then you the stickiness provides you exactly the point what you should
I
treat.
see,
It
yes, of
always put a
course,
clear
yeah.
question, let it flow, and then you have stickiness.
Yes, of course, it's all in the question, isn't it?
Okay.
Can you do it on yourself then? Can you do it on yourself, like self shiatsu, and test the points?
Of course, you can do everything, anything.
You can do anything, right? I knew you were going to say that.
So you can trace the
It's the
meridians,
question, isn't it?
You can find
It's the question.
Points, you can find the deepest levels, you can look locate the cause of structural problems, everything you can do. And I just did that a little bit fast because I want, it's already 40, and maybe I
yeah.
the question after, because I want really to show you how to can use how you can use it for your hara diagnose. Because
Okay.
before, Cliff, you did a hara diagnose on yourself for this supervised
Yeah.
shiatsu self session, and the
That's
finger
right,
test
yeah.
is a very nice tool to do it on your distant sessions with the client. You can
Oh, right.
so easily say this heart, stomach, cerebral, the lung, and you can exactly tell with your test from distance. You have an exact
Right, of
diagnosis.
course, yes. That's great. Yeah, that's a great idea. Yeah.
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 So it's really wonderful. That's why I want to show you that.
Okay.
So this is a long text here. Sorry for that.
Okay.
I will really
That's
explain
okay.
it to you. You don't have to read it. But
Yeah.
the important thing is my hand here, this shape. And you all know this hand from your shadow place. Huh? In your shadow place, this is the wolf or the fox or the whatever. Did you ever play
Yeah.
shadow place?
Yes, yes, like that, yes. Yeah.
So you have two ears here? Yes?
Yes,
So
okay.
you have only the fox. This is a fox, the hara fox.
Yeah.
You have a hara fox,
Yep.
huh? So with this
Okay,
hara
yeah,
fox,
I've got my heart right here.
yeah.
Yeah.
With this hara fox,
Yeah.
You have to put this fox on your hara. Now I have to get a little bit up. Show you my hara. Okay. So you go with this on your hara.
On your own hara, right?
Own hara. We are doing it now on our own hara to experience it. But normally
yes,
you go
course,
to the
yeah.
hara of the client or of the online client. But
yes, do yeah,
also
okay.
to exercise, I did it for many years and I still do check my hara in the morning when I wake up.
Yes.
So you can check. So you can go like a your heart, and then smooth,
yes.
is it smooth or sticky? And most of them are smooth, and just two are sticky.
Wait a minute, you're doing it on the actual, you're using the sensor hand actually on the
yes.
hara, are you? Like this?
Yes.
You're using it like this? Like this?
Like this. But you're touching
Oh,
very
see.
Slightly. You're touching very slightly.
Oh.
Like very slight. So light.
Why don't you just do this though?
Because this the fox, this fox
yeah.
is picking up the most ki or most jitsu ones. If you do it like that, you find every zone sticky.
Right,
but
okay.
The fox is providing you the most ki or most jitsu. If you want to find the zones, where is the zone? You can just the general
okay.
sensor go, right? And you will
yeah.
find sticky the heart. You find sticky the stomach, you find sticky the three-heater, you find sticky the lung. But if you go with
yeah.
the fox, you find only two of them, the most ki or most jitsu ones.
Okay.
So that was a good question. So we go from the heart, your own heart, and let's
So can I just ask a question? I don't think I've got it quite right. So am I feeling, I'm feeling here, am
No,
I?
this is
Where am I feeling
here.
here? Where am I feeling?
Here.
In the testing
Yes.
one. Oh, see, sorry, I got it wrong. So wait a minute, I'm still, this is like the center, and that's the testing still, isn't it? Yeah, sorry, I didn't get it. So this,
Thank
oh, I
you.
see.
Yeah, that's really
Yeah.
wonderful, your question. So we get it really clear because I do it
Yeah,
every
so
day.
this goes on the Hara, and then you test it with this, right?
This is your antenna. This is a special antenna, the
Yes.
FOX. This is
The
the
box.
special Kyoshitsu finder on the Hara antenna.
Okay.
So,
Brilliant.
and then this is the tester hand, it's all the same. So, oh, it is. You can see Ted doing it, but I think we still stay on that. Okay.
Okay.
Well, maybe we go to Ted. Inspiring. So, we go on the Hara and we go together. Now we have the
Yeah, okay,
sensor
let's do it.
and we have this
Brilliant.
hand. So we go heart,
Yeah.
sticky, and then we go
Quite sticky,
gallbladder,
yeah.
smooth or
Yeah.
sticky, liver, smooth or sticky, lung, smooth or sticky, and then back to the heart.
Yeah.
Smooth or sticky, gallbladder, smooth or sticky, liver, smooth or sticky, another time lung, and then
Yeah.
we see where is the belly button, and then above is the heart constrictor, smooth or sticky, spleen, smooth or sticky, kidney, smooth or sticky, and then the bladder, smooth or sticky, then your large intestine, smooth or sticky, and then your small intestine, smooth or sticky. So, two of them are sticky now. Which ones? Did you register one?
Yeah, I've got quite a lot of mine was sticky, to be honest, but apart from the
Shouldn't be like that.
I think it's all the toilet cleaner I drank earlier. No, I'm kidding. No, I've got heart protector and heart quite sticky, actually.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Exactly. I wrote here if many of them are sticky, you choose the two stickiest ones.
Yeah, sure. So you just go for the most sticky,
Yes.
right? Okay. I think it's heart or heart protector. I don't know. They're pretty much the same. I've maybe heart.
Okay. Now
Yeah.
I take questions. Or do we
Okay.
have a poll here? I don't know.
Let's have a look. We've got can you find two sticky zones on your Hara? Do you want that poll?
Yes, please.
Yeah, okay. Okay,
No,
so
that's
see so what yeah, do you want that one?
we are putting a question now, not that.
Okay, so yeah, this is like, can you find that two sticky zones on your Hara? It's about 50-50.
Oh, that's
About the
not
same.
bad. Wow,
No.
that's very
Is
good.
this? Yeah.
Because you did it the first time, it's just a trying out. So a lot
Yeah.
of
I thought.
exercise, a lot of okay, and just trust yourself. Trust your tandem. Trust you. Just
Yeah.
say the name of the meridian, put your sensor, and test, and then. You don't care. You don't think about, oh, which is it? And could it be that? And is it sticky? No, it's
Yeah.
just naturally popping up two sticky sensations, or maybe
I
four.
think that's where I went wrong. I don't think I was saying it clearly enough. You've got to say the it's the question again. It's the clarity of the question, isn't it?
Yes,
The clarity of
yes,
the
yes.
question.
And
Yeah.
the question is just without thinking about
One.
anything, can I do it? Good, am I wrong? Am I right? Am I a good practitioner? Am I finding out all these kind of things the mind does? It's not
Yes.
important at all. You just keep naturally saying heart, stomach, triple heater, lung, and maybe, and don't stay so long here and think about it.
No.
Just, and then pick the two sticky, most sticky ones, and these are the ones, really. And then you can, with your usual diagnosis, you can look with palpations. If it's,
yes.
You know, it's, if you have two methods, you can confirm your diagnosis.
Of course, yeah.
So.
Okay, some people have actually found that they could got it more this time. Someone, I saw someone in the chat saying they, that they got it this time more than the first time when they were doing the testing, the thing that they shouldn't be drinking or whatever. But Helene is saying, is it right? Am I right in saying that the smoothest one is the Kyo, isn't it? And the stickiest one is the Jitsu, isn't it?
Yes, we didn't say this question. So if you have found, or if you have, just take two if you didn't find, because all our songs on the Hara has a Jitsu or a Kyo quality.
Yes.
All meridians, all the zones. The breathing,
yes,
this is a breathing zone. If the meridian is activated, the zone goes bigger, and if the meridian is happy, the zone closes down because it doesn't have to exchange so much.
And no, exactly.
That's why we
find
the
right.
zones. Why we find the active ones, right? So
yes, exactly. Yeah.
So if you have two. If you choose two or have chosen two or have two sticky, then you take your right index finger. This is my right hand. Use it at the other side.
This is my tester, so I'll use this hand. Yeah.
Okay. And then go over the zone.
Okay.
And then ask, is this Kyochitsu?
Is this
Kyochitsu? And then the sticky one is Chitsu. And the smooth one is Kyo.
Okay. Yep, I'm getting that. I can feel that.
Yeah. And you don't have to have it now. It's just an input to really first play around with your liquid, and then after but you are really doing well, like I can see that, and it's a fantastic tool if you just don't give up and just try out and all of a sudden you can let go, and one clear question and the test will provide you the answer. It's something natural,
brilliant.
Naturally happening.
Yeah.
Because and your system will get used to it, your focus.
Several people in the chat are saying that it's similar to kinesiology testing. And I think there is a similarity there.
There's a big similarity there. You can do that with the client for all 12 Hara diagnostic zones, if you wish. It's also a test, but it's a little bit different.
Tiring.
Yes. And there is also a very good test, this one.
Oh yes, I know that one. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, for the kinesiology thing.
But here you have to use both finger. You see?
Yeah.
And this test is just like with the antenna and with the sensor. With the sensor is much more easy to apply.
Yes.
Because you can touch and you can point out. And also your eyes can be an antenna. If I watch you and then I can just put my eyes on you and I can scan what level of what meridian level and what your and for instance Ted, when he goes to the subway and he's half an hour in the subway to downtown, and every person he will test out, you know. Every person, which is the deepest level, what meridian, where is the structural problem, and then the next person. So so your eyes can use the sensor.
Yeah.
So do you have a questions?
Yeah, are there any questions? Maybe Diana can ask us if there are any questions. I can get them up. I've got two here. How is this method more reliable than the normal HARA diagnosis? Sorry, Diana, I was taking your job for a moment there.
I couldn't follow all of what she was saying while I was trying to answer people. So Patricia asked, yeah. Do you use the index finger to recognize Kyo or Jitsu? And my answer was, I think you use it for either once you've got your two stickies. Is that right?
Yes, for this is just Kyo or
Jitsu.
Once
you've got the two sticky areas. And
if you are used to it, if you really train it for a couple of weeks, then it can really be very reliable. In the Shinzo Shiatsu community, we really, everyone, we have one person in the middle, then we have all the same result.
Yes.
So we confirm Brilliant. All the time.
Snezhana wants to know how it's more reliable than a normal HARA diagnosis.
It depends your key level, it depends your experience.
It depends whether it suits you, I suppose. It's like anything, isn't it? Whether you find it, but it can be very dramatic. It's like, it reminds me a bit of dowsing as well, dowsing and kinesiology testing. It's the same kind of thing, getting information, condensing the information into a single thing, you know? Yeah.
For me, I'm really grateful because it's very quick, very light, and I'm very I'm certain about findings. Yeah. I'm really happy I have this gift. And that's why I'm happy to share it.
Krista has a very practical question. She wants to know how deep you go into each HARA zone with the fox.
No, I don't go deep. I just touch lightly on the texture.
Yes.
Yeah, just on the surface.
On the surface, yes.
Yeah. I bet you don't even have to do that as well. I imagine eventually you could probably just think of the HARA diagnostic area and it would be enough.
Of course.
You know, because it's just information, isn't it, from the field?
Of course.
Yeah.
Anything you have a clear question, a clear
intention.
Find out with the also the supplements. Sometimes the clients they ask me for if wheat good for me or coffee or something, and I just imagine coffee for them, and then I get very quickly the answer, very clear.
Yes.
Claire asks, do you ever find the cure with the fox on the HARA? No.
At the kyo, yes, you find the most kyo, most jitsu. You find both with the fox, and after that you have to change your question. Are you kyo jitsu? Are you kyo jitsu? Or is heart constrictor kyo jitsu? Is kidney kyo or jitsu?
Right, and then you test it, smooth or sticky.
Smooth or sticky, and the smooth is kyo, and the sticky.
Suzanne's question is, why would I use the fox when I can directly use the index finger to find out the kyo jitsu?
No, every meridian on the HARA has a kyo quality and a jitsu quality. We have kind of six kyos, six jitsu or something like that, right? But you want to find the most kyo and most jitsu.
Yes.
Where you want to work.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, yeah.
You find first the most kyo, most jitsu, and then among these two, you want to find out which one is kyo and which one is jitsu.
Yes.
And we don't actually believe in the soft and tension ones. Soft can be a tension, and under the tension can be a soft. So the kyo and jitsu is not really very easy to find out with palpation.
Right. Palpation,
method.
Yeah.
You have to be really experienced. And Masunaga really was experienced, and Cliff, you are really experiencing this. But with the finger test,
But actually, I'd go further than that, because with Pauline's work, you see, there's not really that much emphasis placed on the actual texture of the physical body anyway. Yeah. It's more of an energetic thing with a lighter palpation anyway. And you can do it etherically anyway. Anyway, it's been fascinating. It's been so much fun having you on this webinar. It's been absolutely brilliant fun. I've really enjoyed every minute of it. But we've come to the end of our hour now. So I don't know, have you got anything else that you want to quickly show, or are you happy? Have we done everything?
I'm really happy, and I'm looking forward to dance with you in Amsterdam.
Yes,
brilliant.
Brilliant. Webinar. Yes, brilliant. Well, thank you so much. Appreciation, the whole work there. Please give Zita some feedback and find out, just see how, whether you liked it, really liked it. Look at that. You've got a lot of fans there. You've got a massive 90% of people thought it was very good or good. And just a few people did not their thing, which is fair enough. There's only 3% of people did their thing. So that's brilliant. What about fantastic. Thank you so much. Hope to see you in Amsterdam. Huh? Oh, goodness gracious. Yes. Thank you for that. Here's the handout. I'll just share it with you. If you want to download it, you should have a PDF download there, or just make sure that many of you have downloaded it. If you can't download it, something you're on a tablet or something that's a bit too complicated, don't worry about it, because I'll put it in an email to you tomorrow when I send out the recordings. Right. Okay. That's it.
Have a good
fantastic
time. Enjoy.
Yes. Enjoy. Yes. Thank you again. And like I say, I'll send the PDF with the links in it tomorrow. Bye-bye. Okay, bye bye. Thank you, Dinah. Thank you, Dinah, for getting the slides along. Thank you for looking after the chat. And see you in Amsterdam. Bye.